Fluid Management's Harbil 5G is an automatic high-speed paint mixer designed for safety, reliability, and ease of use. Its features include vibration-free mixing for blending and conditioning paint, variable mixing times from 30 seconds to 3 minutes, and the versatility to mix quarts, gallons, 5 gallons, and cases. Some of the important safety features are automatic shutoff if the door is open during shaking operation, and an emergency stop switch for immediate shutdown of the mixer. The mixer weighs 470 pounds and stands at 28 inches wide, 28 inches deep, and 45.5 inches high, so it will easily fit through any standard size door. When receiving your Harbil 5G mixer, inspect the crate for damage. If any damage has occurred, note this on your bill of lading and file a claim with the carrier. Then call Fluid Management Customer Service for further assistance, 800-462-2466. Located on the outside of the box are the instructions for unpacking the mixer. Read the instructions before setting up your mixer. Remove the shipping carton and brackets that attach the mixer to the skid. Then slide the mixer onto another skid or a block of wood and slightly tilt the mixer back. Remove the skid and gently set the mixer down. Don't tilt the mixer back too far, otherwise the super struts could separate. This will cause damage to the mixer when it is powered on. Taped to the front of the machine will be the instruction manual and 2 foam discs. Be sure to read the manual and the warning labels to become familiar with the mixer before proceeding. The serial number is located on the right side panel near the top. Take a moment and write the serial number down in the manual for future reference. Move the mixer to its permanent location. Remove the inner shipping block inserts. The mixer needs to be connected to a separate dedicated circuit. The circuit should be at 120 AC volts with a 20 amp supply. If this is not available, have a certified electrician install a circuit. Please refer to the manual for proper wire gauge sizes to be sure that 20 amps is being supplied. The mixer now needs to be leveled. Assuming your floor is level, the easiest way to level the mixer would be to raise 3 of the legs as high as possible and lock them into place. Then adjust the right front leg so the mixer is sitting level. Tighten the locking nut to secure the leg. A safety switch prevents operation of the mixer while the front door is open, so be sure the front door is closed. Apply power to the mixer by placing the power switch to the on position, then turn the button labeled emergency stop clockwise until the button pops out. With the mixer powered on, push the up button to raise the top plate to accommodate the container to be mixed. The top plate will move up about 2 inches each time the button is pressed. Or press and hold until the plate raises to the desired level. When shaking quarts or 1 gallon cans, place side by side. This diagram shows the placement of gallon cans, blue circle, and quart cans, gray dot, in the mixer. Be sure to center the containers on the table. When shaking 4 gallons, it is best to leave them in the case. When placing 5 gallon metal containers with a recessed bottom in the mixer, use the optional flake board disc for support. The foam disc is used on plastic or metal pails with recessed lids to eliminate flexing. Plastic containers do not have recessed bottoms, so only the lid will need support if it is recessed. Place a container on the table, close the front door, set the timer to the desired shaking time, and press the start button. The paint mixer will automatically move the top plate down and hold the container in place. When clamping pressure reaches a certain point, the shake cycle will begin. If there is still excessive vibration, readjust the right front leg until the vibration is minimized. After shaking the designated amount of time, the top plate will automatically move up. Now you can remove the container. Refer to the placement diagram when shaking gallons or quarts. Use 20-weight oil, SAE20, to lubricate the mixer. For demonstration purposes, the outer sheet metal has been removed. On a weekly basis, lubricate the top pressure plate nuts and lead screws. Both of these items can be accessed through the front door. On a quarterly basis, lubricate the superset pins so the oil will flow down into the bushing. There are 4 struts in the mixer, 2 on each side. These can also be accessed through the front door. Every 6 months, lubricate the crankshaft flange bearings with multipurpose lithium grease. They are located on either side of the shake frame and are accessed by removing the lower shroud. Also, lubricate the pillow block bearings located on the crankshaft. There is a lubrication records chart in the maintenance procedures of your manual. For better parts identification, please refer to the parts section of your manual. If you do not feel confident about disassembling or adjusting the mixer, do not attempt these procedures. Call an authorized service center or customer service at Fluid Management for further assistance. Always remember to shut off the power switch and unplug the mixer before servicing. Excessive noise can be caused by a loose lead screw. To check for a snug fit, try to move the lead screw close to its mount. If there is any movement, be sure to tighten the set screws and be sure the thrust bearings are in good shape. Also, make sure the flange bearings are lubricated. Inspect the flange bearings for any metal shavings or excessive play. If there's excessive noise when the top plate moves up or down, be sure the lead screws are cleaned and oiled. If there's an abnormal amount of vibration, check to make sure that the mixer is level. Use the adjustable legs to minimize vibration and then lock them into position. Vibration can also be caused by a broken spring, bushing, or shaft on the superstrut. Finally, excessive vibration can be caused by a failed crankshaft or bearing. Let's look how to perform these two repair procedures. To change the superstruts, remove the cabinet panels and replace one strut at a time. Hold the pin to remove the top nut. Repeat for bottom hex bolt. Raise up the inner frame using a 2x4. Place a support under the inner frame. This will relieve tension on the pin and body. Now, remove the strut and replace it. Tighten the screws on the struts until the rubber grommets are compressed 1/2 inch. To remove the shake frame, take off all exterior panels. Remove the wires connecting the inner frame to the shake frame. Be sure to label the wires for reassembling of the mixer. Remove the two lower inner frame weights for easier access to the shake frame. The inner frame is attached to the shake frame by the blue swivel rods on the top and the flange bearings on the bottom. Remove the flange bearings by loosening the set screws holding them to the crankshaft, and then remove the 4 screws in each of the bearings. Take off the flange bearings using a wheel puller if necessary. Remove the 2 screws in each swivel rod that connect them to the inner frame. With the assistance of another person, lift out the complete shake frame. Remove all the exterior panels and then remove the shake frame as previously shown. Loosen the 4 screws holding the motor to the inner frame. Remove and discard the old V-belt. Remove the 4 pillow block screws and take off the old crankshaft assembly. The mounting surface must be flat for new crankshaft assembly. Position the new crankshaft assembly by measuring 5 3/8 inches between the crankshaft pins and the inner frame weights, and tighten the screws on the pillow block bearings. Replace the V-belt and reassemble the mixer. Be sure to center the shake frame on the crankshaft. After removing the lower extension panels, loosen the set screws on the flange bearings and slide the shake frame to the right side of the crankshaft. Remove the flange bearing on the right side of the shake frame, use a wheel puller if necessary. Loosen the shake motor mounting screws and slide the motor towards the crankshaft, loosening the V-belt. Remove the old V-belt. When installing the new V-belt, be sure to realign the pulleys. Adjust the shake motor for proper tension on the V-belt, which is approximately 3/16 inches deflection with 5 pounds of pressure. Be sure to center the shake frame on the crankshaft. If the mixer does not start and the on-off switch light is not visible, check that it is plugged into a live receptacle. And make sure the front door is actuating the safety switch. Turn on the power switch and turn the emergency stop button to the on position and press the start switch. If the mixer still does not work, check the 20-amp circuit breaker. There are 2 fuses located on the control box. One fuse mounted to the control panel is a 5-amp used to protect the transformer. The second fuse is a 6.3 amp, which is used to protect the circuit board. If the top clamping plate does not move, check the DC motor for proper voltage, between 40 and 50 volts DC. Check the DC motor cable for any breakage. This would normally occur in the cables between the shake frame and the inner frame. If the top plate clamps on the container but the mixer does not shake, check the shake motor relay by manually actuating the shake motor relay. If this works, replace the circuit board. If this does not work, check the shake motor and cable. The incoming line voltage is split at the terminal block. The first leg runs through the on-off and emergency stop switch. When the switches are activated, the coil is engaged. The second leg runs through the input of the power relay. So when the coil is engaged, the line voltage travels through the F1 fuse to the transformer and to the input of the motor relay. The transformer output voltage is 34 to 37 AC volts, which travels to the F2 fuse to the circuit board. When the start switch is pushed, the 24 DC volt signal is sent through the door safety switch and the circuit board, activating the DC motor. The DC motor runs on 48 DC volts and clamps the top plate down on the container. When the DC motor current peaks, a signal is sent to the coil of the shake motor relay. This closes the relay, and power is sent to the shake motor for a specified cycle time. During the shake cycle, the DC motor receives approximately 4 to 7 DC volts to hold the container in position. When the cycle is complete, the current is reversed to the DC motor and the top plate will rise. When the up switch is activated, the DC motor raises the top plate for a specified time period and then stops. Fluid Management's Harbell 5G mixer has a warranty of 1 year labor and 2 years parts from the date of installation. If you need further assistance or have any questions, call Fluid Management Customer Service, 800-462-2466. The Customer Service Department is open from 7 a.m. to 7 p.m. Central Standard Time. By properly maintaining your equipment, you'll have years of trouble-free service, which will help you maintain customer satisfaction and your profitability. Thank you.